Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss trigonometric functions of angles. Let's start with an example. The question says to find the exact value, and we have the sine of pi over 2. Let's carefully work through this solution. So to find the exact value of sine of pi over 2, you want to think about the unit circles. Here's the y-axis, and here's the x-axis. And here's a quick picture of the unit circle. And the unit circle is special in the sense that every single ordered pair on the unit circle has the form cosine theta, comma sine theta. So at pi over 2, we're up here, and that point on the unit circle is going to be 0, comma 1. So sine is the y-coordinate on the unit circle. So the y-coordinate at pi over 2 is going to be equal to 1. That means that the sine of pi over 2 is equal to 1. And so 1 is the answer. The point is, whenever you have an angle that lies on an axis, for example, pi, 3 pi over 2, or 0, which is also going to lead to the same trig function values as 2 pi and 4 pi, etc., you want to think about the unit circle because you can easily find the sine and cosine of those angles by thinking about the unit circle. Let's go ahead and do another example. Part B, we have to find the exact value of the cosine of 4 pi over 3. This one's a lot more challenging. Let's go ahead and work through it carefully. So the first step in a problem like this is to think about where 4 pi over 3 is on the unit circle. So here's the y-axis, here's the x-axis, and here's pi. You can think of pi as a number over 3, and we're going to do that because we have 4 pi over 3. So that's 3 pi over 3. And that kind of tells you where the angle 4 pi over 3 is, because it starts here, and it must be over here, because it's pi over 3 more than 3 pi over 3. This angle here, which I've drawn in white, is 4 pi over 3. So step one, you draw your angle. Step two, you find your reference angle. The reference angle is the positive angle made with the x-axis and your angle, like this. In this case, this red angle is going to be your reference angle. And it's pretty easy to see because to get from 3 pi over 3 to 4 pi over 3, you just need pi over 3. Now you want to think about the trig function value of pi over 3. Well, that's cosine of pi over 3, which is simply 1/2. So again, recap. Draw your angle, find the reference angle. So step one, find the reference angle. In this case, it's pi over 3. Then you ask yourself, what is the trig function value of that reference angle? 1/2. Now you have to determine what the sine is. Here's a key fact. The trig function values of an angle and its reference angle are the same, except possibly for a sine. Let me say that again because it's super key. The trig function values of an angle and its reference angle are the same, except possibly for the sine. That is the key to the entire concept of trig functions of angles. So we only have to think about whether it's positive or negative. Since cosine is the x-coordinate on the unit circle, and we're at 4 pi over 3, it's going to be negative. So the answer is negative 1/2. So very challenging concept. In fact, let's go ahead and do another one that is very similar to this so that you can get better at this. Part C, we want to evaluate the cosine of 11 pi over 6. Let's work through it. Solution. As before, the first step is to find the reference angle of 11 pi over 6. We draw a quick sketch. And 11 pi over 6 is very close to 2 pi. So here's 2 pi. And so you want to think of 2 pi as a number over 6. That would be 12 pi over 6. And that should tell you where 11 pi over 6 is, because it's almost there. It's very, very close. So it's something like this. A rough picture. It's not perfect. It's just a guide to help us find the reference angle. So this is 11 pi over 6. The reference angle is the positive angle made with the terminal side of this angle and the x-axis. So it's this distance here. So if the full distance is 12 pi over 6 and this distance in white is 11 pi over 6, you're missing pi over 6. The reference angle in this case is pi over 6. So in order to come up with the answer, we simply think about what is the trig function value of pi over 6? Well, the cosine of pi over 6, and this is 100% from memory, is the square root of 3 over 2. Just pure from memory. Now we think about the unit circle. Cosine is the x coordinate on the unit circle. We're in quadrant 4, so all the x's are positive over here. So the cosine of 11 pi over 6 will also be positive, therefore it's the square root of 3 over 2. Quick recap. Step 1, you find your reference angle, compute the trig function value of that reference angle, and then step 2, think about the sine. Is it going to be the same sine, or are you going to change it? Is it going to be positive, or is it going to be negative? These take a lot of practice, and hopefully this has been a little bit helpful. Let's go ahead and jump into something a little bit different. In this example, we're going to find the values of the trigonometric functions of theta, given that the cosine of theta is equal to 1/3, where theta is acute. Let's work through this solution. So to do this problem, we're going to use this. It's SOCACOA. Basically tells us that the sine is equal to the opposite over the hypotenuse, cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, and tangent is opposite over adjacent. So we'll start by basically writing cosine of theta equal to 1/3. And you just basically set it equal to a over h like this. And then from this information, you can draw a triangle and fill it in. So here's our right triangle. And here's theta. So adjacent is 1, that's going to go down here. Hypotenuse is 3, that goes here. And then we can call this side something else, I'll call it b. So you use SOCACOA and you use the information given to draw your triangle. By the way, theta here is acute, means it's in quadrant 1. Now you solve your triangle using the Pythagorean theorem, which tells us that the hypotenuse squared, so 3 squared, is equal to b squared plus 1 squared. So this is 9 equal to b squared plus 1. Subtract 1, so you get b squared equals 8. And then you take the square root of both sides, and so we end up with b equals plus or minus the square root of 8, but we only want the square root of 8 because we only want the positive answer. We can also simplify the square root of 8. We can factor it as the square root of 4 times the square root of 2. To do that, you think about what's the largest factor of 8 for which you can take the square root of that you get a whole number, so 4. So 4 times 2 is 8. And then the square root of 4 is 2, so you get 2 square root of 2. So that's important. So I like to fill it in. Okay, so fill it in. So you solve your triangle basically for the sides. So recap, step 1 in these problems is you use SOCACOA to draw your triangle and fill it in. Once you have your triangle, it's not hard. You can just finish by keeping in mind that theta is acute. So in this case, they're all going to be positive. And you just use SOCACOA to get the answers. So we already have one answer, the cosine of theta equals 1/3. We can get the reciprocal of this right away. So secant of theta, you just flip it. So it's 3 over 1, so it's 3. How about sine of theta? The sine of theta is opposite over hypotenuse, so it's going to be 2 square root of 2 over 3. Right? Because opposite over hypotenuse, 2 square root of 2 over 3. And that gives us cosecant, which is the reciprocal. That'll be 3 over 2 root 2. Now, people usually rationalize in trig, so let's do that. So you can multiply by root 2 over root 2. This is 3 root 2. And then the square root of 2 times the square root of 2 is 2, so you get 2 times 2, so you get 4 on the bottom. So that would be the cosecant. And now we're just missing tangent theta. So it's O over A, so it's opposite over adjacent. So 2 square root of 2 over 1, so that's just 2 square root of 2. And last but not least, we have cotangent of theta, which you just flip it. So that's really over 1, the 2 square root of 2, so it's 1 over 2 root 2. Again, rationalizing is usually a good idea in trig. Most people want you to rationalize. This is the square root of 2, and then 2 times 2 is 4. So here we have our answers. 1/3, 3, 2 root 2 over 3, 3 root 2 over 4, 2 root 2, and then the square root of 2 over 4. So here's the final work answer combo. Hopefully this video has been helpful and you've learned some math. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.